cash-strapped and unemployed, 6 mill workers in Buffalo, New York, came up with a radical idea for making some quick cash.
They perform a strip act at a local pub where they plan to go the full Monty or strip all the way. Now joining us on Mornings to tell us all about the local staging of the hit Broadway musical are the cast, Arnel Ignacio, Mark Bautista, Jamie Wilson, OJ Mariano, Nino Alejandro, and Marco Sison. Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning, guys.
We're
disappointed. You guys are fully dressed. What's going on here?
Oh, half of the interview.
It's cold in here. Yes. It's cold
in here.
It's
all in Velcro.
We'll do it one by one.
Yes.
One piece.
Yeah,
naman. Kaya nga, dito na lang ako. Kaya, ikaw lang ang anchor ko. All right, guys. Well, go ahead, pal. Go ahead.
Well, guys, tell me all about what's going on. Let's talk about this fun project. Who wants to start?
Arnel.
Yeah, I'll take care of the cuento. They get to talk about the details. Yeah, what do you want to know?
Overview. Everybody remembers this great movie from the late 90s, and it's great to hear that it's now back here. On stage, it's going to be a different take on an old favorite, really.
Well, I think it's a pretty good musical in terms of, it's going to be a lot of fun, but mm-hmm. I think more importantly, it's not just about us taking off our clothes, but it's also, it tackles a lot of issues concerning, like, you know, empowerment for men.
Right.
There's a lot of issues about empowerment for women nowadays. Mm-hmm. This is empowerment for men.
Right.
Going into, like, family relationships, relationships with your children, relationships with your lovers and your loved ones, mm-hmm. and basically how that all affects these six men. Mm-hmm. who have this radical idea of going out and making some quick cash.
Right.
See? Ang galing Jamie, di ba?
Haruta na.
Okay. Now let's talk about how little clothing you guys are going to wear. No, but there's a difference. Before we get to that, there's a difference because the movie was set in the UK.
Yes.
And then now it's going to be a little bit different because it's set in New York. Tell us about some of the other things that are going to be tweaked for the Filipino audience or how it's going to be Americanized, at least the story.
Well, the story has been Americanized for us, but I think it's relatable. I think the only reason why they made it more American is because I think some of their accents in the UK are really difficult to sing to.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But I think it's pretty much it. I mean, it's relatable.
Yeah, but it's a story the Filipinos can truly relate to it.
Mm-hmm.
First, six of us have no jobs. Diba?
A lot can relate.
Yes, a lot. Dun pa lang tapos na yung kwento eh. Okay. And then songs are fabulous. Songs, kahit ako hindi ko na-realize, ang ganda pa ng mga kanta.
Mm-hmm,
yes. Mm-hmm. What's my favorite? You Rule My World because that's my song.
Well, this is your, I guess, theatrical comeback. Can we say that?
Para namang ang tanda ko na.
Like you said, I mean,
okay.
Familiar yet yep. new.
Yeah.
How would you describe this?
Because the last time I did theater, aside from Sayon ng Mga Senorita, was when the Rizal Theater was still there, in the space where the Shangri-La now is.
Okay.
See? You don't remember Rizal Theater.
She's
pretending.
Like, uh-huh.
Yeah. She's
there
pretending she knows Rizal
as
Theater.
As far as Ginger is concerned, Rizal was, you know, like...
The Bayani?
Way back.
There was something there before the Shangri-La.
Why do you keep on moving?
I want to explore this. I mean, many of you, are familiar to audiences for other things that you guys do. I mean, obviously, you guys are well known for your TV gigs, your Mark for your singing, of course, also Nina. But you know, this is obviously something different. All of you, I suppose, are no strangers to the stage in one way or another. But this is sort of a whole new level of stage. I mean, considering what you guys have to do for this, Mark.
Yeah. First of all, this is English,
right?
And it's musical. We dance.
Mm-hmm.
And
he's horse.
He's
horse, so, the black man.
I played a black person.
Okay.
So, and I have.
You play a big part here, don't you,
yeah.
Mario?
A big part. And I also dance in this play. So
there you go.
It's an everyday rehearsal, so it's kind of difficult for all of us to. Well, at first, to cope with the schedule. Pero. As we rehearsed, as we know each other pretty good and pretty well, okay naman. It's doing very well. All of us are are dancers now.
Because we have to condition our body, you know.
There's that also. How did you prepare for something like this? I mean, the stage is no place for inhibitions. But I mean, obviously actors, stage actors, throw that all away. But this is, again, going back to what I said earlier, a completely different ballgame. How did you prepare for
it? It was hard because this is my first time to
go
do
naked.
Something, yeah, very liberating. So, medyo kinabahan ako. But as you went through the whole thing.
But so many people are excited to see you naked.
That must be
this
comforting.
This is my first, actually, English no musical. I did, my first play was Nolly, May Tangere. Mm-hmm. And this is my second, so.
Well, we mentioned you guys are all comfortable performing or being on stage, but how comfortable are you, taking your clothes off? Are the rest of you guys taking
your clothes off? Not comfortable.
What was the process like? Now you know what the girls really kind of feel like when they're.
Well, I don't care about what the girls feel.
I must say, during our first rehearsal where we actually took our clothes off, I mean, just do it all the way down to our underwear. We forgot our lines, we forgot our choreography,
we forgot the steps, we forgot.
We were bumping into each other because we just, I'm in my boxers.
Were you checking each other out like, oh, buddy, come
on. We support each other,
Oh, that's
and the
sweet.
Girls support us. Yes. Kasi nagtitext sila.
But here's the thing about, I mean, the movie is about regular Joes who go out there, and then at the same time, you have to balance that with, I'm gonna be stripping down. Maybe I'll do a few sit-ups and a few push-ups. You know,
just
a bit. But you know, you have to balance that out because you're supposed to be playing regular guys.
I guess that's kind of good in the sense that we don't have to look like male Adonises. Like
coming off the everyday guy. Popularity of something like Magic Mike, which was just a few months ago. There's a bit of pressure here, isn't there?
It's totally not like that.
We bring a lot more heart into it. Yes.
You know? More than our bodies, there will be more to be desired.
Well, the story really does ask, you know, at what extent will you go to make some quick cash? You have six unemployed men.
Yeah.
If we could just go down the line for fun, if you found yourselves in the position of your characters, what do you think, what would be that point of no return, or, you know, as far as making some quick cash.
We're talking about realities.
In other words, as ourselves, not as characters.
I mean, would you guys maybe...
This is a good idea.
Of course, sing and dance, but I mean...
Taking your clothes off, it wouldn't, you know... You feel a little uncomfortable the first few seconds, but after a while...
After a while, it goes nuts.
Yeah. It's very liberating.
It's different than, I don't know.
Right.
And what do your significant others say about how do you get support from the loved ones?
I think they're all getting front row seats.
They're all excited.
Definitely.
It's not like they're seeing something they haven't seen before, right?
Yeah, but they're seeing it in a room full of people. That's the scary part.
Okay, so
in
this
a
is
big
different.
Air-conditioned theater.
Right. But it sounds like it's going to be a lot of fun. It sounds like it's going to be, you know, a great ride for everybody. Who's got the details on where it's going to be? Where we can catch tickets and that sort of thing.
Okay, well, it's going to be at the Carlos Romulo Theater in RCBC Plaza in Makati. Mm-hmm. Okay?
That's on April 19th to May 5th. We've got shows Friday to Sunday, Fridays at 8 p.m., Saturdays at 2 p.m. and 8 p.m., and then Sundays at 3 p.m.
Mm-hmm. And for tickets, you can call Ticket World at 891-9999. There you go. And Atlantis Productions, 892-7078 or 637-687-7163.
Is this wholesome family fun? Can kids come along here or even?
I would take my daughter.
Yeah.
I think parental guidance would be safe.
I remember the film well, and it was a feel good movie.
It
was a feel good
movie.
Yeah.
Especially now that all the standard of entertainment now is audience participation.
Right.
There won't be anything like that. You just watch and feel good. You'll laugh, you'll cry, you'll dance and clap.
Because it's all about family relationships.
Absolutely. And looking back to the motivations of why these, you know, your characters decide to go and do this and seeing and studying, you know, where they go from there and what their motivations really were for going as far as this. It's a great study, really, in family and relationships.
Full Monty is so good that you want to pay more for the tickets. Mm-hmm.
Do you want?
Yes. Yeah.
That's the price, but you totally want to say, no, I'm going to add.
This has to be priced even higher.
Okay.
They work so hard.
Yeah, you know,
it feels so good.
Yeah, the story isn't just about guys that want to go out and take their clothes off. You know, it's really about, you know, six guys and actually the whole town's feeling of, you know, desperation, you know, because there really is nothing out there, you know, to help themselves, to help their families. You know, we have a lot of really good, you know, plots and, you know, side stories here that have to do with, you know, parents and their kids, you know.
Me and my wife.
Husbands and wives and friends and everything like that. And it's something definite, you know, you were asking earlier how this can relate to the Pinoy audiences. This is something that, you know, that we all feel every day. You know, we do have to do what we can for our families, for our loved ones. And it's very touching. You know, a lot of people, you know, when we tell them, oh, come watch the Full Monty, they're just like, oh, you guys are just going to strip. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, actually, well, yeah, okay, that's part of it, you know. But it's such a heartwarming story. You know, even us, when we first read the script, of course, you know, you have that idea in mind that this is what it's about or, you know, this is what we're going to do. But then when you actually see the, you know, the backstory and how deep each character is, it's really moving. You know, and I think something that they can definitely relate to.
Well said. I just want to go quickly down the line to say, as far as the performances are concerned on a more comedic front, what's the one thing that sticks out for you guys, especially, I know that, what's the one thing that sticks out for you guys that you want the audience to watch out for? We'll start with Marco.
That's another no pun intended question, really. Go ahead, Marco.
Sides stripping.
Yeah, or, you know, in one of the performances, something that they should really watch out for.
Watch out for my my dance song and dance number. No, I'm seeing the big black man. I'm going to dance in this number. So it's a bit different.
One old solo.
It's a different Marco season.
Mm-hmm. Very different, right? Okay.
Okay, well, something I don't even know if I could call it a word, but something that the people can know is that they can expect from this is. You're gonna walk out of the theater smiling. Yes. Yeah, you're
That's
gonna feel
a great
good.
Thing. All right, OJ.
Yeah. Well, it's something particular. I think you should watch out for this song that I'm going to do with Marks and James.
Yeah.
It's big ass
friendship.
It's a really nice ballad, but it has funny words in it that you really fall in love right away with our characters.
Great lyrics. Okay, watch
something
out.
To watch out for. I think you're gonna be with all our stories. You're gonna be laughing and you're gonna be crying, and there're gonna be some moments in the beginning where you're gonna be laughing at us, but at the end you're gonna be laughing with us, and I think that's important.
Ako yung end part sobrang. Big deal sa akin yon and yun abangan nyo. And I think yung scene ko with my kid. Kasi I'm divorced and I have issues with my kid's custody. So, so medyo
so the human
sentimental
side
and
also.
Emotional.
Yes, okay, and of course.
And it's
Arnett.
Going to be an unbelievable character that I'll be portraying. I'm going to be, I come out as a married man who loves my wife tremendously, giving her everything that I can.
As most men should, right?
All right.
Yes.
D-O-M.
All right, well said, gents. We've flashed the details on screen. It looks like it's going to be a good, fun show. We'll be there. Best of luck. Break a leg.
Yes. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Belated
happy birthday.